Hello all, we're going to let you in for a few minutes here. Welcome, welcome. Now I can't even get the picture up.
It's okay.
Hey guys, welcome, welcome. All right, welcome everyone. We're going to keep letting people in here for a few more minutes.
Hello.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome, everyone. We're going to get started in just a minute. So glad you guys could all come. And if you guys didn't get a chance to join us last week, the recording is on the Astara YouTube page, and I'll put a link in for that as well for everyone.
I wasn't able to do it last week. I don't know how long you guys have been doing it. Who's speaking?
So this is the president of Astara, Greg Toews. And so he's leading the study groups.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. This is Lydia.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Nice to meet you, Lydia. And I'll put that link in for everybody in the chat. And when Greg's ready, I'll be muting everybody when Greg's ready to start.
How many people are?
We have 29.
Yeah, go ahead and mute. We'll get started.
Okay.
Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining us again tonight. We are going to be doing another study group. And so tonight we're going to be talking about consciousness. And consciousness is something that's relatively hard to define, yet we experience it all the time. And so when we go through and we are striving for what we would call higher clairvoyance, part of what we're doing is we're trying to change our perceptions from our lower drives to the ability to perceive our higher faculties. Now, this is done not just etherically, this is done through our physiology. The part that we're gonna focus on tonight is the thalamus, also known as the optic thalamus. Now, the optic thalamus, after our eyes take a picture of the imagery that we see in the external world, part of what happens is that now those impulses are pushed back to the optic thalamus. Think of the optic thalamus as a hub for all the sensory information to be processed and then directed to the appropriate place. So the senses from your skin, from your eyes, the things you hear, the things you taste, the things you smell are all being processed by this optic thalamus. Now, the difficulty is that when we are in states of hypervigilance or hyperreactivity, hypersensitivity, the optic thalamus can become very overactivated or agitated. Now, this is not the things that happen. It is just a state. It is just a state of agitation. It has nothing to do with the information that happened. It's just a state of, it's either relaxed or it's agitated, right? So what happens over a period of time in the nervous system is if we have levels or degrees of agitation, it keeps accumulating. Now, why is the thalamus so important? So part of why the thalamus is so important, for one, it helps to regulate our sleep, right? That is one. Another one is it helps to regulate our ability to focus. Now, if you think of sometimes when you get overstimulated or you get overwhelmed by something, your ability to focus becomes hampered because of all the agitation. This again is tied to the function of the thalamus. Now, also, what is tied to the thalamus is consciousness, right? Consciousness. So consciousness actually is several things. It's not just like you being awake. It has to do with your ability to be inward looking or introspective. It has to do with thought. It has to do with imagination. And when you think of imagination, it's not the ability to make things up. Imagination is actually tied to the function of the heart. Your heart has the ability to perceive things that the mind can't conceive. Right? Your heart has the ability to feel feelings, feel abstract ideas, feel the awareness of just things that are present, even though the mind can't comprehend or can't see them. It has to do with cognition. It has to do with also our awareness and self-awareness. So for somebody to become more self-aware, it's directly tied to the function of the thalamus. So with this, there are different levels or degrees of consciousness. So if we think about sometimes the things that we're struggling with, the difficulties that we have, traumas that we have, difficult people that we have in our lives, we try to go through and resolve these through normal human processes, normal cognitive functions, right? But part of what the thalamus is tied to is basically the ability to change the radio frequency so that you can actually rise above that situation, rise above the difficulties where you can just look down and go, down there I used to suffer, but I'm now in a different stream of consciousness. So this is tied to the drive for higher clairvoyance. You're trying to constantly move your awareness from your lower primal or lower nature drives, your perceptions, and you're trying to shift them to more upper, higher faculty perceptions, right? So this is best symbolized by the sheep and the shepherd, right? Two are looking out at the pasture. The sheep sees basically food and water. Like it just sees, where can I eat? Where can I get something to drink? The shepherd looks at this same area and sees the sheep, sees that the sheep are safe, or sees that there's a predator maybe on the outskirts, sees the seasons, sees that this is good for another few weeks, sees how many sheep are grazing, see which ones are having a difficult time. The shepherd sees so much more. Now, what is the difference? Both are looking at them through their eyes, but the level of consciousness of the shepherd is very different than the sheep. So as a person, as we grow and evolve, especially spiritually, we want to move from looking through the eyes of the sheep and starting to look through the eyes of the shepherd. We want to increase our level to be aware. We want to increase our ability to perceive. The shepherd perceived much more than the sheep. So when you're around people, some people perceive significantly more than others, right? Sometimes a truth is laid out right in front of a person, but they can't perceive it. Sometimes people see deep, deep meaning in simple images on a wall or in a book because there is information in between the lines. So when you have the eyes to see, you start to see higher teachings buried in all the things around you. You start to see love in all the things around you. You start to see the creative process in everything around you. You start to see God in other people and all the things around you. So how do we get closer to this kind of sight? One of the things we do is we calm down the thalamus. We calm down the agitation of the thalamus. There are steps to do to calm down the thalamus, and that is what we're going to practice right now. Okay, so I'd like you to close your eyes for a moment and recall a couple situations in your life. They could be today, last week, last month, 10 years from now. I mean, 10 years ago, I should say. Think about them and think about how they feel and your perceptions of what happened. Just take a moment. Make a mental note of how these things felt and your perceptions. Okay, so keep your eyes closed. Put your awareness in the center of your chest. Put your awareness on your heart. Silently affirm, I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. Keep your awareness on the heart. I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. Hold the image of a spiritual teacher or deity from your tradition, whatever tradition that might be. Hold this image in your heart. Inhale slowly, hold, Exhale slowly. Hold. Inhale slowly. Hold. Exhale slowly. Hold. Just be still, be aware. Keep your awareness on your heart and just be still. Hold the image of the deity or teacher in your heart. Let go of the image and just be still. Move your awareness down to your navel. Just be still. Move your awareness to the top of your head, the crown. Move your awareness to 3 inches above your head. Just let go. Put your awareness on your heart, the center of your chest. Keep your eyes closed and just be still. Visualize a teacher or deity, one that is from your tradition, and hold them in your heart. Move your awareness down to your navel. Let go of all the images and just keep your awareness on the navel. Move your awareness to the top of your head. Move your awareness to 3 inches above the head. Just let go. Again, put your awareness on your heart. Silently affirm, I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. Just be still. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Your awareness is on your heart. Move your awareness to the back heart, the area between the shoulder blades. Om Shanti. 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 Move your awareness down to the navel. Move your awareness 1.5 inches below the navel. move your awareness to the top of your head. Just be still. Move your awareness 3 inches above your head. Just let go. Silently affirm, I am one with the infinite light, and the infinite light flows through me. Visualize your whole body consumed in a brilliant ball of white light. Your whole body is inside a brilliant ball of white light. Continue to visualize the brilliant ball of white light. The white light is getting brighter. We will now be directing this white light throughout various parts of your body. The white light will penetrate through the pores of your skin, all the way to the bone. And what leaves is dirty gray energy through the pores of your skin. As this happens, feel the tension leave your body. Put your awareness on your feet. As you inhale, inhale brilliant white light. Hold. Exhale, dirty gray. Again, inhale, brilliant white light going through the pores of the skin of your feet. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. Put your awareness on the lower leg between the knee and the ankle, the front, the sides, and the back. Brilliant white light is entering through the pores of your skin, all the way to the bone. Exhale, dirty gray. Long, slow, deep breath. Brilliant white light is entering through the pores of your skin. Hold your breath. Exhale, dirty gray. Feel the tension leave. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin, all the way to the bone. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. Your upper thigh, from your knees all the way up to your hips, the front, the sides, and the back. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, the infinite white light through the pores of your skin, all the way to the bone. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. put your awareness on your pelvis, your hips, the front, the sides, the back, and also the floor of your pelvis. Inhale brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. Your lower back and your lower abdomen. Inhale, brilliant white light going in through every pore of that area. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light going through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. Your entire abdomen and your mid-back. Visualize brilliant white light going into the pores of your skin, penetrating all your internal organs, your mid-back, all the way to the bone. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light coming in through the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. your chest and your upper back, the area between your shoulder blades, your whole upper torso. Inhale, brilliant white light penetrating through the pores of your skin. Exiting as dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Put your awareness on your whole arm from your shoulder down to your fingertips. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale, brilliant white light. Exhale, dirty gray. Just be still. Your neck and your head, your whole head. Inhale, brilliant white light coming into the pores of your skin. Exhale, dirty gray. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Just be still, be aware. Just let go. Put your awareness on your heart. Move it to the back heart, the area between your shoulder blades. Move your awareness to your navel. An inch and a half below your navel. To the top of your head. We will invoke for blessing. Just be still. T- To the Supreme God, Divine Mother, Divine Father, to the hierarchy of the holy angels, to the beings of light, to the Lord Christ, to the Lord Buddha, to Master Kutumi, to Lord Rama, to Zosir, we humbly invoke your blessings . May all the listeners, all the congregation, let them be blessed. Let them be healed. Let them be soothed of their pain, their suffering, their sorrow. Let them be filled with compassionate, purifying light, healing, soothing energy. Keep your eyes closed. Just let go. Om Ramo. Just be still, be aware. Gently wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes. Just gently move your body around. How do you feel? Tonight was healing for the thalamus. This helps with increasing sensitivity, the ability to change to higher states of consciousness, and your ability to increase clairvoyant activity or inner seeing. This will continue to work for a while, so pay attention to your dreams. Pay attention to how you feel over the next day or so. At the beginning, I had you reflect on a couple of situations, something that happened in the past Reflect on them now and see how they feel. See if they have the same sting that they did before. Also pay attention if your perceptions of the situation changed. Well, thanks for joining us tonight. We're trying to make these fit into everybody's schedule. So we're trying to stick to around an hour or so. And as some of you know, this weekend is Astara's 69th anniversary. So we'll be celebrating the anniversary. For those of you that have already been sending in your notes and messages, we really appreciate it. Thank you so much. And we will be teaching a clairvoyance class this weekend, Astara's clairvoyance class. So the first of many classes to come. So thank you to the ones that will be joining us. And thank you to you guys for joining us tonight. You know, when I think of Astara, I think of white light. And regardless of what path you've been on or what path you're drawn to, I wish for you to have light on the path. If you turn to us for help, that's great, but there's many paths to the top of the mountain. So I wish for you to have light on the path. So thank you so much for joining us tonight, and we will have another class next week. Blessings.
Also, for you guys who are interested, I'm putting a couple of posts here for the two events.